Thanks a lot. So guys, are you ready to talk about making gains?
Yeah.
You know, I don't care about that. Are you ready to talk about, to learn about making gains? That's not even the most important. Are you ready to apply the stuff you will learn today? Are you ready to apply it?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay, that's good. Okay. So, today I will hold a presentation about making gains because gym is like one of my biggest passions. And before I start, I would like to share my background because for me it's a bit important so you know where I'm coming from. And yeah, I call the presentation the Zebra-Gains Manifesto because I put all my passion, all my work into it. And yeah, so here you can see me. In 2009, I was 16, and I was actually anorexic, and as a guy, this is not really common. I was anorexic because I had a problem with my feet from my birth, and this made that I was psychologically a bit fucked up in some way. I had some issues, and then because of that, I got anorexic. I was depressed, and yeah, at the time, I weighed 43 kilos. And after that, I had an operation on my left leg, and my doctor told me, "Yeah, if you will continue like that, you will die." And this turned something in my head. So I was like, "Okay, I should get healthy." Then I started to work out. I got healthy, like psychologically healthy. I started to work out like every year. I got a bit bigger, and after 5 years, I weighed like 22 kilos more. I was not really fatter, but I was like a bit bigger. And yeah, this became a passion because of that. And now I'm really happy to share this stuff with you. And yeah, before I start, some excuses some people have. I want to dismiss these excuses so you will be 100% focused during my presentation. I have no time. I guess how Michel said last time, if you really want something, you will always find time because you always waste time on WhatsApp, on Facebook, I don't know how many hours. I am too skinny. I will never get big. I should never start. I hear this actually from some friends of mine. They are too skinny. They will never reach what I did. And I mean, if an anorexic little 16-year-old boy can do it, you're not too fucking skinny, right? So, I can eat whatever I want, I will never gain weight. Honestly, guys that tell this to me are in my eyes full of shit. Because everybody can eat enough, that's no problem. And I don't know what to do, because of that you are here. So, let's dive into it. Yo, it's really simple. There are three principles to gaining muscle mass. First, you need exercise, otherwise you will only gain fat. Secondly, you need a caloric surplus. Because the thing is, the body doesn't want to gain muscle mass. Because the problem is, when you gain muscle mass, your body will burn more calories. And the body doesn't want that if you don't eat enough. Because you only give the body the signal to gain muscle when he has enough calories. And the first thing, high enough protein synthesis, I will talk about that. That's like eat enough proteins. So only these three things you have to do. It's really simple in theory. Home workout versus gym membership. Some people ask me like, should I go to the gym? I have no money. And the thing is, I'm not the expert in home workouts or body weight exercises, but there are a lot of good books out there that you can check out. One's name is Be Your Own Gym, something like that. You can really read these books. These are awesome if you don't want to go to the gym. But the gym membership for me is good for the social, for the friends, for example. I've met Michael there and other awesome guys. And how Dale Carnegie says, you're the average of the five people who hang out the most. So if you go to a gym, if you meet people there, you will automatically like have better results. And you also invest some money, so you have more leverage to get the results. So, exercise, yeah. So the basic thing about exercises, Marcus last time talked also a bit about that in the round of your presentation. The thing is, focus on, it's called compound lift. Compound lifts are lifts that activate a lot of muscles at the same time in the body. For example, the biggest compound lifts are the deadlift, where you have the bar and you pull it up with your whole body, where you have the bench press, and the squat, right? I cannot do it with this pants, but the squat. If you do these three exercises, you have like the paleo principle. With 20% effort, you will reach 80% of the results, because with these three exercises, you activate a lot of muscles. And other compound exercises, for example, are the rows, the pull-ups, the military press. I cannot go into detail in all of them, but you can look them up on the internet. They are called compound lifts. So this is the essential. And also focus on getting stronger, because when you get stronger, you will move more weight, and the body will receive more stress from the weights, and then he has to adapt to the stress. And how does the body adapt to stress, to weighted stress? Like with thicker muscle fibers. So it's also called increasing the workloads. I will also talk about that in a couple of minutes. And the other exercises are called assistance exercises, like this biceps curls, triceps push downs, lateral raises, and stuff like that. You can do them, but with more reps, basically. And there you have to focus less on really getting stronger. Only focus on the compound exercise. And yeah, too, there's no best exercise routine. It's a bit individual, but they are like basic principles. Yeah, so the basic principles is that when you start to lift, this mistake make a lot of guys is they start like with four body part splits or three body part splits. Basically, they start to train every day. They train like a different muscle, right? One day they train chest, one day they train arms, one day they train shoulders. But for newbies, this is not the right approach, because when you are a newbie, you recover much faster. So a full body split or a two body split makes much more sense. And I also wrote down, because of the protein synthesis, and I can really explain it to you. It's really simple. So basically that's actually the difference between guys that take steroids and guys that take no steroids. I can really show it to you. It's really simple stuff. So here, for example, you have the time, right? The time you train. And here you have the protein synthesis. And the protein synthesis means basically how much protein your cells are generating with your food, right? When you give the muscle the impulse to grow, your cells will generate protein to let the muscle grow. So when you activate the protein synthesis a lot of time during the week, you will gain most muscle. So when you do like a four part body split as a newbie, you train every muscle once a week, because you have four different days, and every day you train another muscle, right? Most of the guys train like that, also newbies. It's a big mistake. For example, you have the first day, the second day, the third day, the fourth day, the fifth day, the sixth day, the seventh day of the week. So the first day they train like chest, and the seventh day they train like chest. And so you have the protein synthesis, you train, protein synthesis goes up, what you want actually. But the thing is, studies show that protein synthesis is activated like 48 to 72 hours. So you train at the first day, and then the third day it goes down again. Then seventh day you train again, goes up again. So here, protein synthesis is activated. Here you will gain a good amount of muscles, but this part here is missing, right? So the thing you do when you are a newbie, you do full body workouts or two-part body splits. So when you train like full body workouts, it means that every training, I guess Sam does something like that, I'm not sure. Every training, you train the whole body once with not a lot of exercises, but you do, for example, one exercise per muscle group with these compound exercises, and you do every day. You go to the gym, you train the whole body. So here you train the whole body at the first day, second day you recover, right? Third day you train again, fourth day you recover, fifth day you train again. So what you do then, what happens then? Protein synthesis goes up, and right before it goes down, you train again, so it stays. So this part here is used. So this mistake a lot of guys make when you start: train your body, train the muscles a lot, but don't train much time. Just like short, I wrote it down, shorter workouts. That's like science-based stuff. Shorter workouts, but more often. So that's the thing. I also did that wrong, basically, in the beginning. So everybody makes this mistake. So that's the first thing I want to share with you. Yeah, funny picture by now. Do you see it? So now let's say you have a workout, right? Let's say you have like the exercises now, and you know, aha, I have to get stronger. But how you get stronger? How do you have to increase the weight, right? And there's a really, really simple method that I'm also using right now, and this is perfect for beginners. So it's called the 5x5 method. I guess you have heard of it. It's really simple. So let's say you have like your exercises, your basic compound exercises, squats, deadlift, everything like that. And you train the 5x5 method. So basically, you take a weight that you can push. For example, you train the bench press, you take a weight that you can push 8 times. And then you take that weight and you do 5 sets of 5 reps. And when you can accomplish these 5 sets with 5 reps, the next time you go to the gym, you increase the weight a little bit, like 1 or 2 kilos, right? So for example, you do 50 kilos bench press, you start, you do this 8 reps, and now you will lose that, you will do 5 sets with 5 reps. So now when you can do that, this 5 sets with 5 reps, the next time you do 52.5. Again, 5x5, and let's say one day you do 4 sets with 5, and the last set you do only 4, you fuck up. Then the next time you start again, you do it till you reach this 5x5, and then you increase again. That's the simplest method of increasing the weight. And if you do assistance exercises like biceps and stuff, you will do like 8 to 12 reps, for example. Then you can be creative. You can do, for example, 4 sets with 8 reps with the same weight. And every time you can hit 4 sets with the 8 reps, you increase the weight the next time. So it's a really simple technique as a newbie to increase the weight. So you have something in mind to work with. And I wrote down, increase the workload. That's the number one principle. It's written in every book when you read something about bodybuilding. Increase the workload to gain muscle. And this is also a definition of workload. It's really simple. Just to explain it to you, right? When you do 50 kilos with 5x5, basically you do 5 sets with 5 reps. You do in total 25 reps with the 50 kilos, right? And the definition of the workload is just the kilos multiplied by the whole repetitions. So when you multiply that, you will get 1,250 kilograms. That's basically, then it's the workload. And every time you increase that, the body will gain muscle. That's the number one principle. So with this tool, like when you curl 20 kilos, 32 reps, and then the next time you curl 22 kilos, you will gain muscles. That's the number one principle of strength and gaining size. Yeah, it's really cool. Yeah, little summary, because it's really dense. Shorter and more frequent exercises because of this protein synthesis I've showed you. Increase the workload. And yeah, focus on getting stronger long term, because you will also get plateaus, you know, where you can't increase, but you have to stay with it and think long term. Yeah. So, nutrition. It's by Subway, I love it. So, yeah. So, then we need a caloric surplus. I guess I talked also last time about that. And you don't need to be really, really detailed about this whole calorie thing. But you have to know more or less how many calories you need to gain weight, right? Because a lot of guys come to me, they tell me, hey man, I can't gain weight, I can eat whatever I want. But it's exactly the guys that don't track their food. You know, they think they eat like 3,000 calories, but in reality they eat like 2,000 and no idea what. So I have here a quick little app for you. It's called MyFitnessPal. It's awesome. I use it too. It's awesome. It's you can set here. You see, 1,700 calories, for example. You can set a daily goal every day, and then you can type in your food more or less, you know, it doesn't need to be really detailed, and then you see how many calories you have left to reach your goal. And what I basically did during these 5 years, I was gaining weight. My goal was to gain weight, but not gain too fast, because a lot of guys that want to gain weight want to gain 2 kilos, 3 kilos a month, right? But then you gain this amount of weight, mostly is fat, right? So if you want to gain muscle mass, you have to do it really slow and really steady. So what I'm doing, what my technique is basically, I have this app, and I set myself every day. I set myself a goal, and you can also, you have to estimate that for you. But it's really simple how you estimate that. So you just need a number. So you have something to work with. For example, how much do you weigh?
87.
So let's say you weigh 87 kilos, and you always multiply it by the hours of the day. This gives you like the BMR, the basal metabolic rate. That's like the energy you need to maintain your heart rate, your body temperature. And how much is this?
2,088.
Thanks a lot. 2,088.
Yes.
88. Yeah, exactly. So this will be more or less your best basal metabolic rate, and then you multiply it with your activation factor. What do you do? What type of work? Do you sit the whole day?
Yes.
Yeah. So for people that sit the whole day, you multiply it with 1.4, 1.5. Let's do 1.5. This is basically 3,000 calories. So with that estimation for maintaining your weight, you would need 3,000 calories. So what you do, you take that as an estimated number, just to estimate it. You try to hit your daily target like that. And then you do what I've written here. You weigh yourself every day, the same time, you put it into the app, and then you will see a graph, and you will see where the graph is going. And what you have to do, you have to hit like a weight gain of 1 kilo a month, so you are sure you're not gaining too fast, but not gaining too slow. Because 1 kilo a month is like the perfect sweet spot if you want to gain muscle fast, but not too fast. Because the problem is, I guess Henrik also asked me, you want to gain weight, right? And the thing is, if you gain weight too fast as a guy, you will get fatter. And once you have more fat cells in your body, the body can't get rid of them. So once you have more fat cells, you get fatter. Even if you lose the weight again, the body will stay with the fat cells, so they will refill faster. So never try to gain more than 1 kilo a month. It's just useless. You will just get fat and depressed. Yeah. That's the thing you do with the calorie surplus. Awesome app. And how much protein? Yeah, we talk always about protein, about protein synthesis. So in literature, they have written down that like 2 grams per kilogram of body weight is the perfect amount for gaining muscle mass, because you always hear more, like in the media you hear like 3 grams, 4 grams per kilogram muscle mass. But this is more or less a myth, because this whole supplement industries want to sell their protein shakes. So they tell to, yeah, all 3 hours you have to eat protein, you know, but that's just bullshit. So 2 grams per kilogram body weight, so if you weigh like 82 kilos, you do like 160 grams a day, more or less. That's like it's a good starting point. And also, mostly lean sources. I don't like to eat a lot of meat with a lot of fat. I guess you know that when you buy low quality meat with a lot of fat, the toxins are in the fat of the meat. It's a bit bullshit. So if you want to eat meat, try to eat lean meat, even if it's not the best. And then also good fats. I mean, you know, if you want to gain muscle mass, you can eat whatever you want, basically. You won't see a difference with the body you will reach, but you will see a difference with your performance and with your health, basically. But if you want to stay healthy, good fats is a good source, like nuts and basically vegetable fats or bulletproof butter, exactly. And also for carbs, I've written this down because I know some guys here are doing bulletproof. And if you want to gain muscles,
yeah.
Nice. If you want to gain muscles, carbs are your friends, but only at the right times. And what's the right time? I do this myself. I try only to eat carbs after the gym, because the thing is, carbs will also help you to recover with the serotonin that will get in your bloodstream by eating carbs. And the thing is, after the gym, your insulin sensitivity is even higher. So when you eat carbs, your body will produce less insulin to store the carbs in your body. So yeah, if you do, even if you do bulletproof, good carb sources like potatoes, full grain bread, and really slow carb sources are also cool after the gym. But yeah, but to hit your calories, you can eat whatever you want, basically. Quick summary. So focus on eating more calories than you need if you want to gain muscle, otherwise you're wasting your time. Weigh yourself regularly so you know where the weight is going. Eat enough protein. With the rest, you can be a bit creative to hit your calories, but I suggest to eat healthy. And yeah, carbohydrates are good even if you do bulletproof for recovery. So this about nutrition, I also said it, in the theory, it's easy, but the practical thing to be consistent, that's the hardest part. Yeah, so books. Right, some books I can recommend that I've read. Ultimate Mass from my YouTube mentor, Brandon Carter. He's actually also a speed reader, awesome guy. He does gym and speed reading. It's like you have to follow him, it's really cool. He's also a fitness model, by the way, really cool stuff. Starting Strength from Mark Rippetoe. That's basic literature. If you go to the gym, you have to read that book. It's great. It's about barbell training, basically. He only talks about the four main compound exercises, so it goes really deep. Bodybuilding by Frederick Hatfield is also an awesome book if you want to go deeper. Awesome. It's funny, I have read these books 5 years after I started to train. It was so stupid. You also see him like squatting 460 kilos something, like doing the world record. So good offer. Arnold Schwarzenegger, The Encyclopedia of Modern Bodybuilding, also amazing book. YouTube channels in German that I can recommend. Brosep Fitness, he won the natural bodybuilding championship in Germany, and he has really short and dense videos, so anything clear. Smart Gains too, also a German guy. In my opinion, the top YouTube guys there. YouTube channels in English, Brand Carter, also. Kino Body, he's from Canada. He's more about intermittent fasting, but gaining muscle while doing intermittent fasting. And Omar Slav is his name, is also science-based. And yeah, summary of the presentation also at the end, so you get it. Track your training and focus on getting stronger. Set the calorie goal and hit it every day. Try to gain 1 kilo a month. And yeah, be patient because it's a long... Yeah, gym, it's basically, it teaches you about life, right? You have to be disciplined and doing this shit every day for 4 to 5 years, then we'll be okay. Pick sources so I don't get sued. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Amazing.